Hello my friends, Rune here again from Oslo, Norway. Big thanks to Daniel from setram.net. He has sent me some more stuff, including a bag of the new Z68 Slugs, the V2. I have just weighed them on my gunpowder scale, and they are 130 grains, 8.5 gram. They look like so. Hollow base. All that he makes is top quality. And that's not all he has. He sent me a complete valve kit. Let's see if I can open it. I'm going to make a video later on how to install it and how it performs, etc. This is the valve itself, a seal, valve pin, and the screw for the valve pin. It has a separate screw that goes in the rear here. I will show you later when I tinker with it. And this end cap that is sitting here. So that is that. And he also sent me this piece. This is the magazine follower that you must change in order to use the Setram slugs. From what I'm told, it's 3D printed, looks very nice, high quality. So I will also show you how to change that, but not in this video. In this video, I want to try out, because I'm curious, how the Setram slugs performs inside my HDR68. I will try them in both the 7.5 full version and the 16 full version. The 7.5 full version has been opened up. So the valve is completely open on it, and I only get about between 5 and 10 shots from 1-2 canister. The 16 version is not modified. So I have both versions. So let's try out. Seven and a half full version. One thing when you're opening up the valve is that the pressure inside can make the heat core O-ring pop out. It doesn't get ruined or anything, it just pops out of place and falls around the pin. And then you will have to totally disassemble it and put the O-ring back in place. It has happened to me on this revolver. But let's see. Let's hope it works fine. Here you can see the valve block. And I also made a homemade restrictor for it from an old CO2 canister. But I removed it. I want to see what sort of maximum power it can give. So, Umarex brand, CO2 canister. And by the way, you can use Vaseline grease. Just dip. I have some here. I'm going to use it on the slugs. smear it all over, and you can use it instead of the silicone, but since I have that silicone oil, I'm going to use it. And let's take a little drop down there and some on the O-ring. So, temperature here in Norway is getting colder, and it is raining today. It's only like 8 or 10 degrees Celsius, so not exactly hot. So we take some Vaseline. Smear it around the slugs so they won't jam or anything. And then just put it in, like so. I'll do the rest of them. You don't have to see me lubricate all of them. So, and then we will step into my little shooting range and do some power testing. So, 7.5 fuel version with open valve with a Zetram slugs. Heating this, gassing it up. I think it's about 20 degrees here, room temperature, 66 degrees Fahrenheit. So 130 grains Zetram. Well, nice crack. 284. And I'm going to remove it. I don't want to shoot slug on slug. And harder, 289. That is quite decent power, I can tell you. Three, dropping a tiny bit, 269. You get the maximum impact on the first couple of shots, and then it should gradually start dropping. So shot number 4, 259. And 246. Let me do a little reload. I just push them back in. They're still a bit greasy. Say 3 rounds, and I think it will be out of CO2 before I get any further than that. Yeah, sound is lower, 221. Let's take the other one straight away. 109. And I guess that is it. Let me empty out the remaining CO2. Yes. And now the 16-year version with a Cetram V2. So let's see. .245 and .251. .245 again. .245 again, very stable velocity. And again, .245. That is incredibly stable. So, let's do a little reload. I'm not going to grease them up again because they are already kind of sticky from the Vaseline grease. .246. It's amazingly stable. .247. .243. .242. Again, .242. Let's load up again. .241. Starting to drop. .231. Still okay power. .227. 223. And one more. I think we are almost out of gas, so let me empty out the remaining CO2. Like so. So, there you have it. A little power test of the new Zetram slugs, the V2 slugs. From both an open valve and from the 16-year valve. So yeah, big thanks to Daniel from Zetram.net for sending me all the nice stuff. I will make a video of how to change the different parts in my Tiberius later. So maybe I have to wait because my wife is going on a holiday soon, so maybe I will wait until she goes. So I got some time to open up and spread it all around the table here without having to worry about watching the watch, the clock. Yes. Nice lugs and nice revolvers. So that's it for today. Hope you liked the video. See you again another time, and thank you for watching.